the last video I did, I mentioned that I wanted to do some questions and answers. So the first question I got on the YouTube channel was, how do you get out there? How do you project yourself into reality? How do you start making a shift in the world? How do you start pretty much going out there and meeting people that actually resonate at the same vibration as you? And how do you do it all without being afraid? And this is a really good question because, well, I mean, that happens to all of us. We all get afraid. Everyone else is mean. I mean, how could you not, right? It's actually very simple. First thing you have to do is just ask yourself what it is that you want. Once you know what you want, you can go into the world and you can actually start to do it. But you have to be really clear with yourself. You know, where is your passion and where is your heart? Where does your interest truly lie? And if you have an idea about, you know, what you really want to do, then just go and do it and find out how to do it. And make it really easy on yourself too. Perhaps invite you to ask some questions yourself, because I can't really give you answers. I can only invite you to ask your own questions so that maybe you'll find your own answers. If you're having fear, breathe, relax. There's a program I'm working on called Panic to Freedom. Actually, this is Panic to Freedom launch week, where we're gonna be relaunching all the videos and then the full program at the end of the week. So stay tuned for it. Watch, pay attention to Spirit Science of the Week. You'll probably see all sorts of posts about it. But in Panic to Freedom, we talk about a very simple method of moving from panic to freedom and moving from anxiety to inner peace. And when you're in a space of panic, when you're in a space of anxiety, there's actually a very easy way to get out of that. And you could say that that is the method of transcendence, of moving into the lighter space that you want to be in. So you can check out all these videos, but I'll run them through you right now. First, breath in the body. It's basically just, if you don't know what to do, you're panicking or whatever, breathe, relax, calm yourself down, because you can't think if your mind's like jumping all around. That's also partially what it means to get into your heart, is to slow yourself down and to breathe and to feel what you're feeling and actually make sense of the feelings rather than just your mind scattering around. The second is present moment awareness. What's happening right now? Take a look around you. You know, you might be saying, wow, I really want to go and, well, maybe do what I did. Go and travel the world and go and stay with all these people and couch surf and start finding out ways to really move the world forward in a big way. And then you start freaking out. I don't know how to do that. And I had moments like that too. But when you really, you step back and kind of step outside yourself for a second, you're like, wait, is this happening right now? Am I traveling the world yet? No. Okay. Well, what do I need to prepare myself? And you kind of get yourself ready. You get yourself into a space where you can prepare yourself to go and do something. The third is recognizing the story. The story is kind of the idea that you make up, the story that you make up about what it is that's happening all around you. The story is basically you saying, well, I haven't ever done anything amazing in the past, and therefore I'm not going to do anything in the future. Something like that. Or, you know, my mom won't let me, or I just can't do it for whatever reason. And you can find all the reasons that it is. When you understand that there's a story there, you can rewrite it. You tear the page out, you craft something new. You say, you know what? I can do it because I'm a brave young son of a bitch and I can do anything. So let's do it. And then you know, and you gain the inspiration, and that brings you to principle four, which is the inspiration to transcend and finding the inspiration within you to take the steps needed. No, rather, finding the inspiration within you and within something else to do what it is that you want. And it's very interesting because most often the inspiration is actually something outside of you, which a lot of this people in the conscious community, the New Age movement, whatever you want to call it, a lot of it is like a, well, I have some friends who like to call it the New Age circus, but a lot of people always say, oh, you know, it's everything's inside of you and you have to do everything yourself and you have to find the inspiration, you have to find the love all inside you. Okay, that's true, but it's not accurate because the truth is that we're all connected internally and externally. And more often than not, the inspiration to transcend is something big. It's something outside of you. It's for a loved one, someone who means a lot to you. It could be someone really close to you, or could be something you want to create, something in particular in the world, something specific, or Maybe it's just for the world itself. You want to transcend your limits to help change the world in the biggest way possible. Whatever that looks like for you. And when you find the inspiration to transcend, then that completes the circle and you grow. And that's kind of the process, I think, of getting out there in the world, doing what you really want. Find a way to make it possible. For me, when I, well, I don't know if whether you know my story or not, it's not the most important, but it's a reflection of your story, I'm sure, in a number of ways. But I basically said, well, I want to travel the world and video document it. So I found a used iPod Touch online, bought it, started doing video blogs, edited it, put it on the internet, and I was off. I started traveling, and I have only been home once since, for a month, middle of last year. That was a lot of fun, too. I went there with the Atlantis King. It's kind of, yeah, it was a lot of fun. Then we fought the Styx. There's a funny video. You can watch it right there. It's irrelevant, too. Let's get rid of it. So in conclusion, as I'm wrapping up, I think we've put together actually a really powerful program all about this, which I've been going over, called Panic to Freedom, and this week we're launching it. So if you pay attention just to the Spirit Science website, Facebook, Twitter, whatever, we're probably going to be making a lot of posts about it. Also, you can just check out paniktofreedom.com, which is really, you know, for everybody out there who's who's going through this kind of stuff, this awakening, wants to open up more, wants to be more, learn more, do more. I think we've put together something that's really going to help. So check it out if you have some time. If you don't have time, make it. It might really help. So without further ado, have an absolutely great day. I'll talk to you later. Simple as something that nobody knows. Her eyes are as big as a bubbly toes. On the feet of a queen of the hearts of the car. Feet are infested with tar balls. And la da 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 da. La da da.